Hello guys, my name is Yash. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will learn about packages and how to use them to create modular code in Java. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Also, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe so that you don't miss any updates. A Java package is a group of similar types of classes, interfaces, and sub-packages. Package in Java can be categorized in two forms, built-in package and user-defined package. Built-in packages are existing Java packages that come along with the JDK. For example, java.util, java.io, java.lang, etc. Java also allows you to create packages as per your need. These packages are called user-defined packages. You can find two date classes in Java. However, the rule in Java programming is that only one unique class name is allowed in a Java project. So how did they manage to include two classes with the same name date in JDK? This was possible because these two date classes belong to two different packages. java.util.date, this is a normal date class that can be used anywhere, and java.sql.date, this is a SQL date used for SQL query and such. Java package provides access protection. Java package is used to categorize the classes and interfaces so that they can be easily maintained. Java package removes naming collision. To define a package in Java, we use the keyword package. For example, if you are not using IDE, that is Integrated Development Environment, you need to follow the syntax. The D switch specifies the destination where to put the generated class file. The D is a switch that tells the compiler where to put the class file. That is, it represents destination. The dot represents the current folder. Java has an import statement that allows you to import an entire package or use only certain classes and interfaces defined in the package. There are three ways to access the package from outside the package. If you use package.asterisk, then all the classes and interfaces of this package will be accessible, but not sub-packages. If you import package.classname, then only declared class of this package will be accessible. For example, if you use fully qualified name, then only declared class of this package will be accessible. Now, there is no need to import, but you need to use fully qualified name every time when you are accessing the class or interface. It is generally used when two packages have same class name, that is java.util and java.sql packages contain date class. For example, if you import a package, all the classes and interface of that package will be imported, excluding the classes and interfaces of the sub-packages. Hence, you need to import the sub-packages as well. Package inside the package is called the sub-package. It should be created to categorize the package further. The package name must be unique. Hence, there's a convention to create a package as a domain name, but in reverse order. For example, here, each level of the package is a directory in your file system. If you like this video, share it with your friends and also don't forget to like.